Hello and welcome to another episode of Tester Speak, and I'm your host, Brijesh Dev. Well, with me on the screen already is my dear friend, Shailesh Gohil. I have been following his work for a while now, and I must say that I have been super impressed by the things that he's doing. What impresses me the most is the fact that he's got started with his own testing community in Ahmedabad, called CSQA, and I want to know more about it. I want to know, how did he get started with that, or have the energy to, you know, get something like this going, and how is it going for him? So we'll find out more as we speak more to Shailesh. Welcome to the show, Shailesh.
Hey, Brijesh. Thank you very much for inviting me for this. I really humbled. And before I start anything, I really would like to thank you and all the three enablers of the test chat. Since the time I joined, probably in last May, June, I got to know really good things. I got to meet really good people and all. So yeah, that's really fantastic. This Tester Speak and WIT are really good, and I'm really glad that today I'm part of that. I'm speaking as one of the best.
Well, Shailesh, thank you so much for all those kind words, but I have to confess this, okay, that I should have got you sooner on the list. You know, the list, obviously every month it is growing, and I had you marked for the month of March, but then a week or so ago, we did a Chatterbox episode together.
Yes.
And, it was then I realized that, you are probably the only one who is yet to be interviewed, who is there obviously on the list, but is yet to be interviewed. So I should do it sooner. And the funny thing is that we have a date set up on Valentine's Day. That is today.
Yes.
So, but then, nevertheless, it does not take away the fact that you've been doing an incredible job with the community. So I would like to know, how did you get started with testing?
Sure. So it's interesting. Actually, when I have completed my BE, I have done my Bachelor of Engineering with IT in Ahmedabad, from Ahmedabad. So when I finished it, I couldn't make, there were like 3-4 companies came for a campus interview and I couldn't make it. So, and then the college has been finished, and I was coming from a lower middle class family. I couldn't like wait and for the jobs, or I go somewhere and find. So what I do is I started finding a job in Ahmedabad itself. I got a job in very first week of finishing everything. That is the job of a programmer. I was a PHP developer. And I started with that. While I was doing that, I heard about some other openings in some of the company and testing. So when I was in college, there are a couple of seniors who are working in Putney Computers, which is Capgemini now. But it was Putney Computers, and that time it was working only on testing. So Putney has very big setup in Gandhinagar that time, which is near to Ahmedabad. Then lots of people are working in there as a tester. So I got to know about the tools like WinRunner, that Silk Studio, that Test Director, all these things I heard from our seniors.
Yeah.
And all.
Yeah.
So I was a little bit fascinated.
Historic era.
So I was a little bit fascinated about that. And while I started my job as a programmer, I heard about testing job, and I knew that they are paying really well, 4 times better than what I was getting that time. So I go for an interview, I cracked it, and I decided, okay, why should not I start with that? It was very low amount in programmer job and good amount in testing. So I started with that, thinking if I won't be comfortable, I will move back. Another thing was, while in the college, I was, whatever project I was doing, I was just working majorly on the Java stack. And I got a job in PHP, so I really want to work on PHP. And the journey started And very first week, I get to know that what we need to do is testing plus support. 15 days we need to do night shift, 15 days day shift. So in the night shift, I mean, after a month as joining as a tester, my job was like pick up a call and whenever got any customer that support call and okay, I'm Shailesh, not Shailesh, but some English name we need to keep and how may I help you and we need to give that software support. So I was really fed up that, oh, what is that? And I started learning testing on my free time. And after a couple of months, I left that job. But that job actually teach me really good things. The thing that I used to talk directly with the customer who are from USA. So the foreigners, the foreign accents and all, we don't understand that. I learned. I used to give the sales demo. And in the daytime, we need to do the upgrade. It was a desktop-based application which is developed in Power Builder and all. So when you need to upgrade such application, you need to copy all this file, do that database query execution, and then you update. So working directly on production, what is the risk? How are the things we need to take care and directly upgrade the system on production was really, even at this time, if I want to do that, it's a very risky task. I learned that thing. So it was good. And after 9 months, I got another job in Mumbai as a tester. It was a pure testing job. And that was the company where I actually learned the testing. I met some of the finest people who has teach me the QA processes, different type of testing. I heard about the Wien Runner and all that time. When I joined that company in 2007, Selenium was very new. And I was fortunate to get some training on Selenium. I started the Selenium Core, RC, not even RC, the Selenium Core, when you need to use that Selenium's language, if you remember, that you need to have three tags.
Yeah.
So you need to write in HTML and that you need to save as a Selenium Core HTML file, you put that into Selenium Core server and run it. So yeah, that way we run, and it was Selenium RC way back 2007. So that was the company where I learned all these things. After some time, there was a requirement of performance tags, and my seniors told we are using Grindr, you start with that. Again, Grindr without any UI and all, when you just need to capture the script, and Jython was a very heavy name for me. So that I actually learned the testing. And after spending around 3 years, I got an opportunity in Baroda, which is in Gujarat. And I thought, let's go back to the hometown. Generally, people don't prefer when they are in Mumbai, they prefer to be in Mumbai or they go to Pune, Bangalore, etc. I actually moved back to Baroda as my brother was also working there. So I thought, like, let's have it there and all. And after that, I'm working in Gujarat only. Around 3 years I spent in Baroda. Then I moved to Ahmedabad. I joined a company in Ahmedabad. And that's a place where I started training different people on different technologies. And I actually loved it. I loved giving back. So I started taking interviews and I got to know that, okay, what's the level of people? What else, like, they require, there is a like really a need of shaping up them and all. So I started training people and all. And my last company, which is Enblex, where I am since last 5 years, that's something I joined as a QA practice lead. So my job was to take care of everything in QA. So where I actually have seen all the phases in QA, be it sales and marketing, pre-sales, delivery, recruitment, like everything. So that's what actually gave me a little idea about each and everything. While working in that company, I also got a chance to be a project manager, full-time project manager, or end-to-end project management for around 1.5 years. So I was doing that, but again, that QA in my heart was just telling I want to again move to QA because that touch was not there. So again, move back to QA. And again, I'm working as a QA only. So that's there. Also, I worked as we set up a new vertical in RPA. I was adding that. I set up a whole team of RPA and all. But yeah, it was there was no QA in that RPA thing. It was a purely RPA people who actually undergone those RPA training, and we are working that. We are not comparing, or we are not pitching to any customer who are expecting any QA related solution. We are pitching RPA, but the people were actually the need RPA and all. So I got that particular exposure over there. So that's there. And while just doing all these things, also like when I was in Mumbai, 2008, there was some conference from Accenture, and it was in Hyatt, I still remember. So the reason that it is from Accenture and it is in Hyatt with free entry and all, I have attended that. That was my first full day conference, and it was quite good. And from that particular day, I really liked that. Okay, these are the really good thing. We got to meet many good people. We got to hear from experts and all, and it should be that. So a couple of such things I have done in Mumbai. And then nothing was there. So when I moved back to Ahmedabad, I thought we'll start something. We have that, then something. So we were doing some meetups and all in bits and pieces. And this is where we just land up then. So that's the overall journey I do have.
That's quite an interesting one. Because, to join with, doing QA and then service support and then coming into project management, going into QA, setting up something for RPA. I think you've done almost everything that somebody can actually wish for in their career. So it is quite a wide thing. And that brings me up to my next question. You mentioned something very interesting, and this is just purely out of curiosity. Okay, I've heard people in the BPO world that they have to change their names to American names or British names. Why did you have to do that?
So I asked that question. I mean, so I was undergoing the training. After the training, when I was starting that support job, I have been told, "You are Steve." So I said, "Why Steve?" So he said, "Shailesh is a very big name. They cannot pronounce it." So that's the reason that everyone should have some English name. So there were some people like Jai or like some names. So they were not changing their name because it was easy. Otherwise, everyone were just putting something.
Yeah,
and then it's a tradition.
That happens a lot with Chinese names also,
Yes.
They are very difficult to pronounce. So they do have an English name, which is kind of very different. But I was just curious about that. Now, so when you transitioned yourself from being somebody who's done testing, who's learned automation, into say the direction of project management, did you not feel that, okay, this is something that I want to do? Or what was the reason why you again switched back to testing?
You just cut in between. Can you please come
again? Are you able to hear me?
Yes. No.
So what I was asking is, you transitioned from a tester to a project management role, but then you came back again to testing. So was it not something that, okay, project management is something that you would like to do or continue? Why did you switch to testing?
Yeah, so that's not like I didn't like that. That was again a challenging role. And before step into the project management role, what we all think that what PM is not doing anything, or PM is just something, what we have seen, and we are just talking like that and all. So I just started as a PM, and I was the solely responsible for that project, be it a delivery, controlling the cost, tracking the daily cost. We need to manage that gross margin or P&Ls and everything that I need to do. And to manage that, you need to control the cost. You need to monitoring your schedule. You cannot go out of that. And those things were also quite challenging. You need to be on top of that. You need to coordinate with multiple teams, multiple people. You need to do a little good customer advocacy. So I like those things. But when I was doing that, I was not able to do anything on technical side because all these things require a huge amount of time. Also, one thing that I learned, probably in the first one or two project, I got failed also because I tried to do some hands-on. So you need to stick with your role. When you are a project manager, you should be a manager or a leader. But a project manager cannot be go into the good hands-on and all. If you just try to do that, maybe something else would also get just missed or something. So that was the reason that I would like to do some hands-on as well as leading management activities. So I come back to QA wherein I'm able to do those things. So working as a practice lead, working as a vertical lead or something, I'm able to do the hands-on on technical side. And that's the only reason. So
That's a very interesting point. I want to draw your attention to something that was discussed in the recent panel discussion that both of us were a part of. And in that discussion, our host, our dear friend Naveen Kunteta, he mentioned something really interesting. And I quite agree with it. In fact, all panelists did agree with it, that, you know, today we need more of technical managers, people who understand technology and have the skill of managing people. And he made a very good point with that. So here I hear you saying that, okay, we should excel in the role that we are, in, and doing two things at a time is difficult. How do you respond to that situation?
All right. So that particular discussion that you are pointing out was more what I believe is technical manager and the people management.
Correct.
Two things. The another point that I told is all about the overall account management, or where you need to take care of P&Ls and all. So if you are working for some product company, those things won't come into the picture, wherein project manager, he just need to deliver.
Right.
And all. But service-based company, those things also come into the picture. I was working, the Renblix was a small firm. So where a PM is the person who is responsible for everything. There isn't any account manager, then another, some other hierarchy is not there. There is me and then the delivery manager. So when you're working with some company, there are multiple roles you need to deal with. But yeah, technical manager, it is really good role, and the people management skill, it has to be there. But one thing I would like to say in that front is, it is not only for the technical manager, but each and everyone who is leading a team of at least two people. When it's a two people, then we call it a team. It's two people or 2,000 people team. You need to do a people management. And it's challenging everywhere with two people or 200 people or 2,000 people. And it's not about what I believe is, when I done the project management, I learned many things. Even I compare many things with real life also. So if you compare this people management with real life, we all are doing good people management over there. We are elder somewhere, we are younger somewhere. We need to deal with the elders, we need to deal with the youngers.
Yes.
So those things are the people management. Everywhere in college time, we were doing. So if you actually gone into those things, you definitely be a good people manager. And if someone said, I'm not a good people manager, then the question is how you are dealing in your society, how you are dealing in your real life.
Exactly. Very well made point. I think that is a great analogy. Thank you for clarifying, that response. So, that brings me to my next question. Now, when we talk about testing as a skill, you've seen testing and testers evolve over a period of time. And Is there something that you would want testers to do a little more of so that they are able to excel in their careers?
Sure. So on the scaling or the evolving, the core things are still, I feel it remain as it is. When I have learned testing, I learned about BVA or equivalence partitioning or a couple of different methods. Or we were doing just decision trees, decision tables and all, and just to derive the test cases and all. Those things are still as it is. Long back, I read some blog. And it was like, it was probably Srinivas Kulkarni only wrote it. I don't remember exactly, but it's either Pradeep, both of them. But it's more about like what changes in the testing industry in last 20 years or something. If we compare with other things, there were some new languages came, there are new tools, there are new metrics, so many things. On if you think about development, if you think about networking or whatever, it was a networking or infra. Now it's more on the like, obviously not, DevOps is not the only that thing, but like so many things came in that. But if you're testing in last couple of years, we have more tools and all. But if you think like 4 or 5 years back, things were not much evolved. But now we do have more tools which actually make our life easy in terms of data generation, in terms of doing writing automation, in terms of doing some performance testing, in terms of doing security testing, in terms of testing our APIs, or whatever things we do. Even like many add-ons available when you are doing exploratory testing and all, it makes life easy. The mind map is something that actually we can say one of the good things that we have seen in recent era, which actually helped us to put the things. It was there, but I mean, we have not named anything.
Right.
But it was there, but now we are just doing it mind map. I mean, why I'm telling, because when I say I learned testing in my second company in Mumbai, and it was my first project, someone told that create flows so you can, it will be easy for you to write the test case. So I started writing creating flow charts. So if I remember that, it was not a flow chart, it was a mind map, but we call it a chart, so flow charts. But now it's a mind mapping, so all the test, our test right. journeys, we are able to do that and all. But still, the core principles are still it is, be it agile way or be it a waterfall way. Still, we are doing the same thing. If I think of what we are doing in waterfall, we are doing the same thing in agile also. But the iteration, the duration is small.
Right.
We were writing test cases for 1 month. Here we are writing for 3 days.
Right. Absolutely. Absolutely. No, I completely agree with you on that, Sailesh. And I think you've brought a very good perspective. And that draws me back to something that you said in response to my previous question about RPA. Okay. And a lot of testers have this confusion. I'm in a testing role right now. Is transitioning to RPA a good choice, is the question that I often get. So I want to ask you the same question. Is transitioning to RPA a part of the progression for a tester? If yes, why? If no, why not?
Sure. So very first thing I will say, RPA is robotics process automation. It is not test automation. That is first thing. In test automation, we are checking few things. We are comparing expected versus actual in terms of assertions, in terms of checkpoints. In robotics process automation, we are just automating a process that a manual worker is doing throughout a day. A banking worker is doing many things in a day. A receptionist is doing many things in a day. And we are just, and those are the recursive things, the same thing that they are doing. We are automating those things. That's the basic idea about RPA. If anyone is not aware, at least they can get to know about that. So there is a difference between them. But to automate, the processes look similar. What we are doing in automation is we are playing with the UI. In the RPA, we are playing with the UI. So it looks similar. The process is similar, but the way is similar, but the actual intention, or both has different directions and different aims, different delivery point. What we want to achieve is different. So we need to understand that point. Now, if I come to the aspiration, whether I need to move to this or that, this is your career. You have decided to be a tester. You can decide now, after being a tester, you have decided whether you want to be an API automation tester or performance tester or a test automation, whatever you know, one thing or multiple things that you have decided. You have decided whether you want to go to leader role, management role, architect role, or you will be deciding if you are a junior, junior, and if you are going ahead, you will be deciding that. So again, you can decide whether you want to go to DevOps or not. Similarly, RPA is one particular category in IT industry. You can decide whether you want to go inside into that or not. Yes, as I said, the process is similar compared to the other people into other stream like developers or DevOps or UI people. It will be more easy for you to take a first step with RPA because you've done some automation.
Right.
But before you move into that, you need to understand the industry. What is RPA? Where it will be applicable? What could be the market of that? So when you do some certification, when you there are like some good RPA tools which are providing some good courses and certification. So there is no harm learning that, because any learning will be benefited to you. So you do some study, some market study, you can do some research, you learn something, and then you can make your mind what will be the feature of such thing. What are the challenges? RPA is what I thought is it is taking the baby step. We are hearing the words like cognitive intelligence or cognitive automation, intelligent automations. So when RPA will be clubbed tightly with AI, chatbots and all, it is there, but not that tightly integrated and not everything that we are able to do. Once right. those things will be there, RPA will be really booming. It will take time. And nowadays, whatever tools are there in the market, they are also like, it's very costly or something. I mean, if I think the QTP, I learned QTP, but I couldn't implement much because of the costing. Company cannot afford, any company cannot afford QTP or LoadRunner or such tools. So when Selenium came into the picture, being open source and free, everybody has started adopting that.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So same thing is happening with RPA, because I have, run the whole practice, I have been part of many client demos, have created many POCs, proposals and all. I knew that it's difficult when it comes to the costing and all. So if people are not using that, there won't be a demand, much demand of RPA developers. The second thing is you need to know about the life cycle. When you are doing the test automation, that's a recursive for a project. So till the time the project is there, that particular testing, functional testing, API testing will be there. RPA, when you automated the process, okay, you are done. Now we don't need much people, only one people to just maintain that. When we are implementing, there might be requirement of 15 people.
Or maybe two more people to,
yes.
to make custom adjustments to a process if there is a process yes. change somewhere. Yeah, I completely agree with you. And in fact, I also wrote a recent blog on the differences between test automation and RPA. And a lot of testers still have this confusion. So, you know what? And people give examples like, okay, you can do UI test automation using automation anywhere. And I'm like, yeah, of course you can do. Of course you can do. But if you want to, say for example, put a screw in a wall, will you use hammer? Just because the hammer can be used, will you use a hammer? You will use a drill to drill it inside, right? And then maybe tighten it with a screwdriver. But will you, just because you can do it with the hammer also, will you use the hammer for that purpose? No. So exactly what you're saying, and I am happy that, you know, a thought leader like you is talking about this topic and is willing to clarify that to a lot of testers who have this question. In fact, I was a part of your CSQA meetup yesterday, where, you know, there was this beautiful discussion about DevOps. I think it was carried out beautifully. Some wonderful questions that were answered. And I saw a lot of people getting confused and saying, oh, can I become a DevOps engineer? Can I become this? Of course you can. If you understand the technology very well, if you have the skills, definitely you can, right? But as a first step, understand, when you look at something like DevOps, understand the culture, understand, you know, what DevOps actually entails, what is the purpose, what are the requirements for infrastructure and things like that. And then maybe take small steps, not like, okay, today I'm a tester, tomorrow I will be a DevOps engineer. It does not happen that way. And I want to thank you for first of all, setting up the CSQA community. And secondly, for taking up such brilliant topics for discussion. And it brings me to my next question for you. How did you get the inspiration of starting CSQA, and what has been your journey so far?
Sure. So yeah, I told you in my introduction that I attended one event of Accenture, and it was quite good. Well, I was in Mumbai, and a couple of such events I attended in Mumbai. So I was quite happy with that. And it's like I'm learning new things. I'm meeting new people and all. When I moved back to Gujarat, I was in Ahmedabad. There was nothing like that. Nothing was happening, or nothing much was happening, or probably not in my knowledge if it is happening at all. Maybe it was on small scale or something. But I wasn't aware about that. So I thought, like, why we don't have that thing? I used to heard about some conference in Bangalore, some conference in Europe, Eurostars and all that happening. So, but I couldn't travel to Bangalore. I mean, Ahmedabad to Bangalore, just taking leaves for 2-3 days. You need to do much arrangements and all. So I couldn't go. I thought, if it is in Ahmedabad, at least I can go. Then I was part of that weekend testing for quite some time, thanks to a channel. So it was again good thing. Then back in 2015, I joined AndBlitz. It was Nova at that time, and they were doing some meetups. So I know that. So we have done one first QA meetup, and it was quite good. It was interesting, and we took only around like 100 registration. We got 45 people that time. There wasn't much format and all. We could decide it, but yeah, there was 2 presentations and we were happy. Then we were doing that, but not regular basis. We decided, okay, we'll do the next event, but that is after 6 months, 8 months. And it was an event only. Then suddenly in my mind was like, I was just discussing with another friend who is also doing this meetup with me, and that we'll do something, or we'll do some panel discussions online when this lockdown happened and all. So we were just discussing, we'll do something. And I saw Phase. Phase. It was a Phase LinkedIn post, and I got to know about some discussion happened on Sunday for the test chat, and there was a link of test chat. So I joined that WhatsApp group, and I was quite happy to join that WhatsApp group. In fact, slight out track of my answer, but the day I joined the group, I saw that second tester speak of Shefali. I saw that and I was quite happy. And that time I also thought, like, mera number bhi aayega hai nahi. So I'm here. So I'm
quite happy. Today, yeah.
Yes. So
I'm happy that you are here.
Thank you very much for that. And then that time also Test Tribe has that tribal conference, and then VP and all guys have that another conference. I forgot the name. That is from Step In for a conference also.
Yeah, yeah.
So we were just a group of people. There was one WhatsApp group who were doing such events, and I thought that let's do some events, but not event. Let's form a community. And let's do that. So something should be on regular basis. then we got support from a couple of people. Niranjan was there. He's from KiwiQA, the TTN community.
Yes.
He's from Ahmedabad.
Great guy.
Yeah, he's great. So he's also from Ahmedabad. So we know each other well. And he told that, okay, whatever support you guys need, and I'm also there. So we just formed community. It's a like community is a that's we formed a WhatsApp group, and I have some good connects with people. So we got many people over there, and then we decided, okay, next month we'll have one event where we have decided, okay, this will be the format and two presentations followed by the panel discussions and all, and we have done it. After we have done it, I got many messages on WhatsApp and LinkedIn from people around who has attended that, or people who come to know about that, and they actually appreciate all these things. We started getting support. After a couple of days, even we had the discussion on those Slack things and all, and you also like appreciate, and you told that, okay, I have joined that. So it was quite good to meet. I was kind of humbled. Okay, so people are supporting, people are giving support. So it was really good to me, and we got some boost. So next month we decided to have some workshop. So I and another friend, we have hosted a 4-hour workshop on Jupyter, which also went really well. So that's how journey started. And then whosoever I have approached, Sanjay then, Sanjay Kumar, that can you take some workshop on SelectHub? He said, like, why not? I'm really happy. And even he told that due to this pandemic, we'll do the online, but once it will be over, even I'll travel to Ahmedabad, I'll take that. I was quite happy that, okay. So that then I get to know that there are quite a couple of people who also think like me that, okay, if you are doing something for a community, we are there. We are there to support you all the way. If you want us to be speaker, we are there. I spoke to Mahesh and I asked him, just come for 15 minutes, give some idea about the test flix. Before a few days of test flix, we have an event, and he was also got ready. Recently, I mean, this next week, we have one event on security testing. So a few weeks back, I approached Vandana Verma. She is a director, one of the board of director in OWASP.
She's a
security specialist in IBM.
I know Vandana, yes.
So I was not sure what she will tell, but I just thought, let's give it a try. She told that I'm more than happy to give such thing.
Yes.
So that again, like, make my belief true. Okay, people are ready. You already told that, okay, whatever you need, you just let me know. Sachin told me that, Pace told me, but everyone has told that, okay, whenever you need anything, just let us know. And that actually boosts our energy. So we are doing at least one or two events in a month. And the overall idea is, there are communities, there are test chairs, agile test areas, and so many different communities are there already. But then, like, one thing, being a hiring manager also, I have took many interviews of the people from Ahmedabad, and I thought that, I feel there is a gap between people who is working on tier 2 cities and tier 1 cities. Probably it's a communication, probably it's a lack of confidence. So they are not attending the conferences, they are not being part of other events, speaking and also they are not being speakers. And also the overall idea is to provide them some platform to enable themselves. So what I always keen is someone from that group, someone from that community come up and give some demo. Even though they are not expert, just do something.
Correct.
Because when someone give half an hour presentation, he or she needs to just prepare for 4 to 5 days. 2-3 hours every day or something, or it is like at least 8 to 10 hours effort, then only you will be able to like collect all the material, create the presentation you need to practice when you are doing for the first time. It's not for you, but for the first timers.
Yeah.
So that's the intention, and that's what we are going with. So the DevOps thing that you told, so Maulik was there. So he's one of the co-member of CSQA. He's also helping out. And he told after this particular session yesterday that, Shailesh, I have done this thing for the first time with that many people. There were around 160 people. So he told that it was really good for him, and he actually scanned a lot while he was preparing all these things. He has done a lot many research.
Yeah.
So that's the idea that we are doing that. And again, another core idea is when the pandemic will be over, we want to go offline, because offline events are really good on retro.
Absolutely, absolutely. There is no doubt. And I must commend you for what you are doing. I must, the day when you announce that, okay, there is a CSQA community, and you put out that message in the test chat Telegram group, you know, I was so delighted. I was like, okay, so this is so good to see that people are trying to do this for the community. Okay, yes, there are a lot of communities. Okay, there is Ministry of Testing. There is the Test Tribe. There is Agile Testing Alliance. We have the test chat, CSQA is there. There may be many more, okay? And it does not harm us in any way if we are a part of multiple communities, okay? Like, for example, I am very happy to be a part of the Test Tribe. You know, the kind of events that do, you know, Mahesh's leadership is so inspiring. You know, the kind of dedication and devotion that he shows. And I participate in their discussion, sometimes comment, sometimes ask a few questions. Similarly, you know, Mahesh is a part of the test chat, and he contributes. He has appeared on Tester Speak. He will soon be appearing on one of our AMAs. So which is, you know, which shows that, okay, if we are willing to share our knowledge, if we are willing to share our thought process with the larger community, it becomes an inspiration for a lot of testers. And what you did by that small announcement that, okay, we are starting CSQA community, it was like, I was so jubilant that day. I was like, this is exactly what we want people to be doing. And then you said, no, you have plans of taking it offline once the pandemic is over. Excellent thought. You know, I would love to be a part of CSQA, you know, do some sessions online. And again, when the pandemic is over, I would like to visit Ahmedabad, of course, and you know, speak to you guys. Just that experience of talking to testers, it is something which is phenomenal. And I would like to say and tell this to all the testers, you know, wherever you are in the world, if there is an opportunity. Okay, if there is an announcement that you come across that there is a community which is hosting a meetup or a event or a conference, please attend. It is very important. Sometimes we think, oh, it's free. It will be there on YouTube later. We will watch it later. Trust me, that later never comes. And I'm sure, Shailesh, you will agree that it's with us also. If we do it sometimes, oh, maybe I'll watch it later. We do not get the time to go back and watch it. And sometimes we simply forget about it, right? So this happens a lot. So that's why it is good that we take part in these live events when they happen, you know, participate, ask your questions, because not only is this a good opportunity for you to learn as a tester, it is a great boost for the speaker who has spent hours, maybe days to prepare for it. For example, you were talking about Maulik's example yesterday. I think Maulik did a phenomenal job yesterday. Okay. It never appeared that he was doing this on such a grand scale for the first time. He was very confident. He passed on the right message. He answered the questions really well. And I've been so impressed with what he did. It is really good. And I want to thank you for setting up this community, CSQA community, for testers in Ahmedabad, testers in Gujarat who now have access to such a forum. And if you go offline post-pandemic, it'll be very interesting and very important for the testers to be a part of it. So, sorry, I'm taking a little longer than I should. It is your Tester Speak session.
But
when it comes to community building, I get a little more passionate, a little more carried away. And that's why I want to make this point very emphatically. Guys, if you are in the vicinity of Ahmedabad, if you are able to join a CSQA, please do. please attend their meetups. Okay. And, you know, I'm going to put the link and things in the description, put a link to the CHKA community YouTube channel also in the link of, or in the description of this particular episode. Because Shailesh and the entire team of CSK, you guys are doing great. I think it's very important for testers to take advantage of it. You know, we all want to learn. We all want to achieve something in our career. But what happens is if we share what we've learned, then it not only helps us get to where we want to go in our career, it also helps us in helping other people get to where they want to go in their career. And that is something very important. Thank you so much, Shailesh, for setting up the community. Now I want to go to the next segment of my interview. I see that we are running out of time, but we will go a little longer than scheduled because I want to do this. So this is the rapid fire segment. You must be aware. So, you know, a few simple questions. You don't get more than 5 seconds to think about an answer. It has to be instant. And if it is multiple choice, then you will have to clarify your choice. Okay, so here we go.
Sure.
I understand your favorite city in India is Ahmedabad. Is that true?
Yes.
Yes? Okay. So what's your second favorite city?
Second favorite... I went to London once, and that's what I have seen and also, yeah, that will be.
Oh, London is a beautiful city, except for the weather. It can be nasty sometimes.
Yes, actually, I visited in November, December, so weather was not
my
good.
God.
But still, it's very beautiful. Yeah,
it's beautiful.
And I was in outskirts. I was out of the whole four zone. I was in Kingston. So again, like, it's very beautiful. If you're going out of
Kingston, is nice. Kingston is nice. Yeah, I mean, London and the suburbs in the outskirts are all beautiful. I mean, there is a lot to see. There is a lot to experience. And compared to India, especially with the weather being different, you know, and especially if you're talking about winter, when I can give you the example right now inside this cozy room, I have set my heater at 24 degrees. I'm sitting comfortably. But I cannot step out because if I look at my phone and check the weather, it says minus 12 degrees. Okay. And it snowed last week, but now all that snow has either melted away or has turned into ice. Okay. And when it turns into ice, it becomes slippery. So I can't even go out and take a walk. So usually, typically the last 4 days have been really bright and sunny. But despite the sun, it's very difficult to go out and walk. It is. So, all right. London being your second favorite city, what's your favorite food except Gujarati food?
Oh, that's tough.
Except Gujarati food.
Oh, yeah, that's tough. That's what I told. Because the favorite one obviously come into Gujarati. But if I think out of Gujarati, actually, I'm a foodie and there isn't nothing like a favorite. Everything is my favorite and I'm always up for any food. So, and it's not even like mood or something. So that's a tough question for me. I'm a big foodie. Big
I'll make it tougher for you. I guess I'll make it a little more tougher for you.
Sure.
I'm assuming that you're a vegetarian. Are you?
Yes.
Okay. So what's your favorite vegetarian recipe outside of Gujarat?
Yeah. So I like everything, but yeah. I'm more inclined towards the South Indian food, be it a dosa or be it like those penduras and all. But like on that, I like those authentic style and authentic taste. So when I was in Chennai a couple of times, I was there and whatever I had over there, such foods or when I go to those Andhra Mess and I eat those rice with different some chutneys, Oh, those are the good outside.
That's amazing. Don't remind me of that early in the morning. it's early morning for me. So thinking of good old Andhra style vegetarian meal. I mean, that's superb.
No, yeah. Whenever I went to Chennai, I never had breakfast in hotel. I went to those roadside restaurants only because those are the actually authentic.
That's the trick, you know. If you visit any city other than yours, even in your city, okay, even if you are in Ahmedabad, if you go and eat in a restaurant, it'll be totally different compared to eating something very simple, okay? Something like Dhokla, okay? If you eat in a restaurant versus if you eat with a street side vendor, there will be a world of difference, I can tell you this. Okay, and from what I see, you know, there are so many food shows nowadays on TV, and there is a lot of coverage on street food, especially in Indian cities. So I watch a lot of those programs. So I know that Ahmedabad also offers a lot of street food. And when I see that, and the choices that are available that are simply incredible. So I understand why you are a foodie now. So I understand your choice. Well, that brings me to my next question, and this is something to do with testing. If Shailesh was not a tester, what would he be?
I would say I would be some event manager or something. That is again like one of the things that I really liked and I really enjoyed from my school time. I mean, when I was I was in school or I was in like 6th, 7th standard, I used to do all these Ganpati Navratri things and all in my society compound and all. When I was in college, so I have started like doing, in fourth semester, I was part of the core committee of the technical symposium that we have, those robotics paper presentations and all. And then in the next two technical events, I become the chief coordinator. So those 2-3 people who are the in charge of that. So I actually enjoyed that. I have done a couple of functions and all. When I was in Mumbai, we formed a group. We called it Page 3. And we are the helping hand of HR at that time. We are doing all the events. Whatever festivals are coming, it's we are doing all this thing. And we are quite good in that. So that's why, again, I like those arranging all these events and all.
Awesome, awesome. And that shows very much in the way, you know, these ESQA events are organized and brought out. So it is good to know. Of course, we at the Test Chat are also coming up with a few events. So I know exactly whom to approach now for guidance.
Definitely.
So please expect my call. That's what I'm going to say. Now, before I let you go, one final question. What's your message two final questions. What's your message for testers in general? What message would you like to give them?
The two things I would like to say. One is never be in comfort zone. Keep upskilling, keep learning new things. When I say learning, it is not only Selenium, it is not only DevOps or Jmeter or such tactical thing, but anything. Like when we were discussing something, I got to learn from you that, okay, how to just take such interviews. So that's something I can consider as a learning. It can be for your life. It can be not only technical or professional, but we need to keep learning every day. So don't stop your learning. Whatever age you are, whatever experience you have, if you stop that, you will obviously start feeling that I'm not in demand now. I people don't need me and also. And another thing, when you were you were asking everyone to be part of CSQA attending events and also. One request to everyone, the whole community, the whole QA ecosystem, that there are a lot many people are doing many things. people are doing, like contest is nearby or some tests are level. We have like test tricks was there. So test tribe is there. There's one community. Test state is there. CSQA, Ministry of Testing or Agile Test Alliance. So there are lots of different communities that you will be come across, and they are doing many events and all. Everyone are doing that with an intention to upskill people, to encourage them to be speakers and all, to provide some platform to enable. And while they are doing that, it takes lots of energy, it takes lots of time, lots of planning. If you are like doing some full day event, there are like 1 month of planning is behind that. So that's a request to everyone to register for such event, to attend those events. If you are registered, at least you should go, not for full day, at least for a few hours. Whatever time you have, you should go and that. Because the turnaround ratio is really low. Always, we are expecting 30%, 40% people turn around. That will demotivate the people who are just working behind it. Obviously, those are the people who don't really need to motivate on that because they have some agenda in their mind to enable people. But to keep them motivated, they won't be demotivated, but you need to boost their motivation so they can come up with more and more such events for you. That's a message for whole community. So that will I appreciate.
Awesome, awesome. Thank you so much for highlighting that once again. I think it is very important for all testers to recognize that there is a lot of effort that is going behind these communities and these events where, you know, the speakers are taking a lot of time in preparing. In fact, you know, just take the example of this particular interview. You know, Shailesh has had to spare his time, has to do preparation for coming in here. I have had to do my preparation. So there is some value in us doing this talk. Okay. And similarly, if there is a particular discussion that is happening where somebody is trying to coach you on a subject, for example, yesterday Maulik spoke beautifully about you know, DevOps, and he spoke about the career path and stuff like that. It was good that there were 160 people, but I'm sure a lot more had actually registered and they should have all turned up. Okay, so that would have given confidence, more confidence to Maulik. It's not that he needs it for himself. It's that the message that he's spreading, if it reaches more people, then it makes Maulik happier. And second thing, it makes your life easier. And I'm taking just Maulik's example, because that was something that I attended yesterday. But I think you are all very wise to get the message. Thank you, Shailesh, for pointing that out. This brings to my last question for you, Shailesh. What does Shailesh do when he's not testing?
Okay. So when I'm not testing, a random thing, sometimes I do read some books. And I actually personally like to read Gujarati books more. There are lots of things in Gujarati literature that is I'm not able to finish. So I first go for those. If I don't have such options, then I took any other random, but more on the novels, fictions, etc. Still motivational or such books are not, I'm not able to read those things much. So that was I do, or I watch TV or when I'm free. I watch with my son, like at least 2-3 times in a week, we watch some South Indian movies that we like actually. So those are the things.
I love movies from the South. They are so brilliant. Yeah. What else do you like doing?
All these things are like just like in last couple of months, just planning for all these activities and all, like actually make me very happy. So I spend a couple of time in that as well. Need to go out or sometime. So those are the things that I do.
Awesome.
Nothing in special.
Awesome. Thank you. Thank you so much, Shailesh. I mean, it was a pleasure talking to you today. It always is. I mean, you bring in so much of knowledge, so much of energy. And, you know, I'm glad that finally we could do this Test to Speak session. like I said, I should have done it much earlier, but I'm glad that we did it today, and that too on Valentine's Day.
good Valentine's Day.
It shows that not only people can be in love, communities can be in love too. So
exactly.
We want to spread the message of love between all human beings, and
that's
the thing. I am really thankful to you, Shailesh, for your time today, and just go out there, enjoy yourself, have fun. Excellent initiative started with CSQA. More power to you and to your team for doing such an incredible job. Thank you so much, Shailesh. Sure.
Thank you, Vijay. And it's really a pleasure to have a word with you, to talk with you, and also thanks a lot.
Have a nice
to day. Everyone in TestChat.
Yeah, cheers. We'll talk soon.
Yes, bye. Yeah, sure. Bye.